name is Jade from the Bosco and Drummond, and I'm here with actor and actress Stuart Dunne. Thanks very much for agreeing to the interview. Where were you originally from?
I'm originally from Drummond.
Yeah.
Drummond, I was.
Yeah.
Around here.
Very good.
Around the field.
Oh, yeah, I know. Were you ever in the Bosco?
I was, yeah. I was a member of the Bosco when I was younger.
Really?
Yeah.
Did you play for any of the sports teams?
I did gymnastics actually.
Really?
With a guy named Tyson, John Tyson, I think his name was. And there was a guy, another guy called David Cody.
Yeah.
Who I always admired, he was very good at gymnastics.
Mm.
Yeah, so I did gymnastics in there for a while, and I did boot repair.
Boot
and shoe repair.
Fixing your shoes.
Yeah, fixing the shoes and ladder work as well. Mm. And I did drama with Finbar Howard.
Oh, really?
He was the one that taught me on to acting.
That's how
I started as well. That's where you're at,
you know. That's where I'm all again. And that was just about to be my next question. How did you get into
acting?
Yeah.
Well, it's a long story. I suffered with dyslexia, and I wasn't academically. I wasn't very good at school, and I remember I did my group, and my mother said to me, "What are you going to be, you know?"
Yeah.
She thought like an apprentice or something.
Yeah.
So I said I wanted to be an actor, and she just sort of, coldness came over her face. And it's only in the maturer years that I'm in. Looking back on it, I'm sure she said to herself, she was like, "I'm sure I can't even read." So, anyway, I went off and I was a coach builder that I didn't enjoy at all.
Yeah.
I wasn't a very good coach builder, but I was a coach builder. And then after that, I went to a place called the Focus Theatre and studied under Deirdre Connell and Mary Elizabeth Burke Kennedy.
Yeah.
And a few other well-known actors and directors in Dublin. So I studied for about 5 years. I didn't really want to be on stage, I just wanted to understand about acting. And then after about 4 or 6 years, I decided that an opportunity came up that I'd do a play by Tommy O'Neill.
Yeah.
And that was really the first So then it just went, I then decided I wanted to be a full-time actor. And became a full-time actor. You see, the thing about becoming an actor is you can say, "I'm an actor."
Yeah.
You don't need anything. All you need is the work.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I became an actor. And when I was knocking around, you know, and a young actor, it was very vibrant, there was lots of theatre companies, and
yeah.
It's as vibrant today, I'm sure, even more,
yeah.
You know, which is great. So then, I always had an interest in art, and I began painting, just painting for myself. And then I wanted to do a character study. I decided to do a character study on Vincent Van Gogh through method acting in 1986. And I worked on the premise of doing a character study for a certain length of time, which was 3 months. I wanted to live the part, what they say, live the part. So it took me from 86, a career in acting, to painting, to actually 2009,
yeah.
To do the character study. So it took me 20 odd years to get to the stage where I could put things together and do a character study, and I did a character study on Vincent Van Gogh's last 70 days in a place called Anvers, which is about 13 miles outside Paris.
Yeah.
It's where his last 70 days were. I know the reason I did it was because there was a block there, you know.
Yeah,
He was a prolific letter writer, and he used to write with his brother who supported him. So I did that, and I ended up sculpting 5 pieces of sculpture. Some of them are over there, and those 70 paintings and these paintings up here are all to do with the Van Gogh character study. from the character study, we filmed it, and it ended up, there was what I call, it's a character, it's Vincent van Gogh character study with a narrative.
Yeah.
It's a 12-hour film.
Yeah.
It's not a film as film, but it has a narrative and storyline.
Yeah.
That came from the character study. The character study was a really interesting thing to do, because when you take yourself away from your own life, your bills, and you move out of your family, you move away from your family, and you move away from your friends, you move away from your routines, and put a whole lot of strangers around you, you become something else.
Yeah.
And that's what I wanted to do. And I went down, like, before that, I got my teeth taken out, I got my front teeth taken out, because my gaff had no teeth. And I was, I wouldn't be sure to tell you the blog, you know.
Yeah, yeah.
So I wanted to interfere with my own ego by taking it, getting the teeth out. So every time I smiled, you'd see a gap in my mouth.
Yeah.
And so I'd have to deal with that, all these new things going through the character study.
Yeah.
And it was a very interesting character study. You know, from a guy who left school at 14. But I went to the Bosco. Had I not gone to the Bosco, I don't believe I would have really got the foundation to seek achievements.
Yeah. Did you go to the Bosco when you left school at
14? No, when I left school at 14, I started working, and that gives you other money to foolishly waste on drink and
everything else.
And other things, yeah. Yeah.
So what's your current plans for the future? What are you working on now?
I'm working on a sculpture piece. I'm sculpting this painting here.
Yeah.
It's called The Girl Who Raised the Flag. It's to celebrate Manon Aherne, the women of Ireland, their strength and their participation in 1916, which I don't believe they were ever celebrated.
Yeah.
This girl, she raised the flag in 1916 at the GPO, and we forget about that in our history. All I see in our history are, of course, I have great admiration for Pierce Connolly, McDonough, all those people, but today's politicians are fat cats sitting in the Dáil who are 50-odd, who scream republicanism, and the amount of women in the Dáil and the amount of women in business and the amount of women that professions are undermined by men.
Yeah.
I think men have ran the state for the last 90 years and made a complete and utter hazard.
Mm.
And I think now, when we look at the great women of Ireland, like Robinson, Mary McAleese, Maud Gonne, hundreds of women, you know,
yeah.
I mean, they just need to be celebrated more. So I'm going to do a big bronze piece, a life-size bronze of the girl who raised the flag, and with the support of the Irish women, I'm sure, and I'm looking for support from all Irish women, to place them in the Connaught Street at the GPO, because I think that's where it should be celebrated. Women in Ireland need to be celebrated. They need more recognition.
Yeah.
I believe.
Yeah, and is that going to be soon?
I'm sure the big fat cats in the government know it. But I'm telling them now I'm going to place them on the street.
Yeah.
With the help of the Irish women.
I'm sure you'll have to support the Bible.
Well, do give me the support.
I will.
They get me on Facebook, Stuart Dunne.
Stuart Dunne.
And put up the Irish women.
Okay, thanks very much, Stuart Dunne, for your time.
Thank you, it's been a pleasure.
I'm looking forward to seeing the piece now on the street.
Yeah, with your help.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.